Surely you would have seen a snail or a slug after rain. Do you know that these amazing creatures are not insects at all? These are gastropods. Let's find out more about them. Today there are over 60,000 species of gastropods. They all belong to a large taxonomic rank of invertebrates within the phylum Mollusca, which means that they do not have a backbone, their bodies are soft and are usually protected by a hard shell. Fossil evidence suggests that gastropods first appeared over half a billion years ago. This means that they can be considered some of the oldest inhabitants of our planet. The first gastropods were exclusively marine, but already had a shell. From here, from the ocean floor, they began their journey around the planet and over millions of years spread across the world. Most gastropods have remained to live in marine habitats. These are sea snails. They have a head with two tentacles and tiny eyes. They have a muscular foot that compresses and allows crawling along the bottom or burrowing into sand. Do you see this long tube-like structure? This is a siphon through which water is drawn into the mantle cavity and over the gills for respiration. Most marine gastropods breathe with their gills. So gastropods have lived in the seas and oceans for many millions of years, but after some time, some of them got tired of living there. The most daring decided to venture out of the water, but this path was long and hard. After all, when they lived in seawater, they used gills for breathing, and then they would stick out and immediately dive back again. The air dried up the gills and made it impossible to breathe. Then mollusks adapted to retain water inside the shell so that the gills did not dry up so quickly. Even now, there are many snails that live near the tide line but still breathe with their gills. There are coastal snail species such as limpets, which live throughout the intertidal zone attached to rocks or other hard surfaces. Some snails living on open coast have gills too, but go back to the water only to lay their eggs. Other gastropods, having left the sea, have adapted to live in fresh water. Freshwater snails are well known to aquarium hobbyists, who often keep them as natural tank cleaners. Probably land snails originated from freshwater species. As snails ventured onto land, they swapped gills for a primitive lung to breathe air. Land gastropods also have two additional tentacles for feeling the habitat and searching for food. Initially, all land gastropods had a shell, but some species dispensed with all or most of their shell at some point in their evolution. That's the way slugs have evolved. However, very few people know that there are also semi-slugs to be found in the natural world. They have tiny shells attached to their bodies that are way too small for them to retract into. Snails carry shells with them throughout their entire lives and retract into them when sighting enemies. But on the other hand, slugs can shrink or stretch their length in order to squeeze through extremely tiny cracks and narrow gaps. Although most land snails have adjusted to live on land, they like wet weather best. They will die if exposed to the sun because it burns their skin. Therefore, during hot, dry periods, snails estivate, and slugs hide deep under stones or logs in order to retain the moisture crucial for survival. Basically, slugs are brown in color, but some of them are festively colored species. For example, this giant hot pink slug, which incidentally lives on just one mountaintop in Australia. And look at this banana slug. Despite the name, it does not eat this fruit, but the yellow coloring makes it look like, yes, you've noticed, a banana. Both snails and slugs stay moist thanks to the mucus they secrete. Look what a trail they leave behind. Snails and slugs can use this slime to climb walls, tree trunks, or large stones. Gastropods mucus has unusual physical properties. Scientists inspired by slug slime work hard to develop an antifreeze for airplanes. In the future, it is planned to come up with an organic gel and apply it to the aircraft's wings and tail. Also, based on the mucus of some slug species, scientists have developed new adhesives that could replace medical glue and sutures. There are also slugs which are marine dwellers, and these are called Nudibranchs. They're arguably some of the most beautiful and stunning creatures in the ocean. Like land slugs, they have completely lost their shells. They come in an amazing variety of shapes and colors. For example, this is the blue dragon. And this strange sea slug looks like a green leaf. When these weird animals eat algae, they suck out the chloroplasts and incorporate them into their own bodies. Meet this adorable sea bunny sea slug. True to their name, which translates as naked gills, nudibranchs are further identifiable by their exposed gills. However, appearances are deceptive. The bright colors of nudibranchs are an adaptive strategy, so that predators are warned of poisons or nasty-tasting chemicals. Thanks for joining us today. We hope these incredible creatures that live next to us on our planet didn't leave you cold. See you next time.